Zero Wrestling Television, former Ideal Opportunity briefcase holder Stevie James takes on Richy Sick in our main event.
But before we get to that, let's throw it over to our newly crowned champion, Tommy Corbin, baby! Woohoo!
So, Shane Daly, the general manager, wants me to face Biohazard for my World Heavyweight Championship. Yes, sir. Right away, sir. I'll play along and I'll face Biohazard because that's what the fans want to see, okay? And that's who the fans want to win. They want Biohazard to win. But I got news for you, fans. Biohazard is a bug. A creepy, crawly pest that I will personally smack down. Because Biohazard isn't even in the same league as me, okay? Get a clue. I am Tommy Corbin, the wrestling machine, the best athlete in this business. I'm the top chain champion. I'm the man, okay? Not this masked little whiny loser at the bottom of the... Shane Daly, my belt, you want him to win? That's fine, because here's what we're gonna do. You see, I'm smarter than you. I've been in this game longer than you have, and I know what it's like to be the general manager. So I'm gonna walk right into my title match. I'm gonna look at that bug-eyed creep from across the ring. I'm gonna wave goodbye, because I'm gonna, right when that bell rings, I'm gonna step outside the ring and get myself counted out, clap my hands, dust off my boots, get in my car, head back home, and I'll still be the World Heavyweight Champion. And we all win, don't we? Everybody goes home happy.
There he is, folks! A new attire, a new attitude!
Alright, yeah, Malibu Stacy got a new hat, and who gave this guy mic time?
This guy is going to give us a dose of tough talk.
Some of you will sit there and tell me that Project Zero Wrestling is what PZW stands for. Now, after careful consideration, I've deciphered what PZW actually stands for. Penny Zero Wannabes. Because none of you are actually wrestlers. None of you have actually been trained like myself. And none of you possess the superior wrestling intellect, the superior intellect in general, that I do. It's just that simple.
Amen. Amen, Tom.
Oh, shut up over there.
Shut up, you.
And the only other man in this whole building who comes close, even remotely close, but not that close, to my intellect, is a man who made his fortune as a fish stick baron. The man who's become known worldwide as the Grand Shah of the Bizarre.
Boring.
He is undoubtedly the man in Project Zero Wrestling who I am most sexually attracted to.
What? You talk too much.
Ladies and gentlemen.
What?
KM Cash.
Oh, jeez.
Absolutely fantastic. A segment with two people that I love. Could this get any better, Joe?
Well, yeah, because I didn't know we were going to start doing public service announcements on this program.
There he is, folks. My cousin, KM Cash. This man is going to make an impact in Project Zero Wrestling.
This man, along with Tony Spencer, are the best example why abortion is still legal in this country.
Well, that's your view, and keep it to yourself.
Now, Mr. Cash, please. I hope I didn't upset you too much with that sexual attraction remark. But it's true. You are. Go ahead. Pose for them. Look at this stunning individual right here.
Oh, outstanding. Oh, you know, they should be hugging because he's consoling the man.
Mr. Cash, I've brought you out here not to discuss your lucrative fish stick business or your world-renowned status as a thriller of fat Japanese women.
Woo!
Tell me about Derek Simonetti.
Yeah!
Exactly, but seriously, woo! Derek Simonetti.
Oh, the fat guy with the
great big piece of trash.
Oh!
Apparently he's got a title shot or whatever coming up.
That's not justified. That's not justified at all. That big fat sack of garbage doesn't deserve a title shot.
What about me? He's more
we all know who the number one contender really is. Richy, sick. I can agree with that. To a point. So would you say that Richy Sick has the upper hand against Derek Simonetti?
Yes.
Now, I wonder what Derek Simonetti's opinion would be about this.
All right, I've never heard anything more open-ended like that invitation.
Cue the taker!
And business is about to pick up.
Derek Simonetti cannot mind his own business, folks, because quite frankly, he always has an opinion on everything.
Well, let's be fair, Owen, this is his business. They just spent the last couple minutes talking garbage about him. They called him fat. They called him a fat sack of garbage. And as far as I'm concerned, he's probably the most dangerous man in PZW. So why would you want to piss him off, especially if you don't have Malcolm Xavier in the ring with you?
What makes you think Malcolm Xavier would just sick anybody who's not waiting to get the crap out of this guy?
We know Richie's in the building, but let's see how this turns out.
Myself in this building, but I think it's about time you shut up.
Yeah.
Most sensible thing I've heard all day.
Matter of fact, I think it's about time you start talking.
Ooh.
I've been listening to this ever since this started. You haven't said more than three f***ing words. And honestly, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna be the nice guy here, okay? I'm gonna give you this mic back, I'm gonna let you finish conducting this interview, but I wanna hear exactly from the horse's mouth himself.
Yeah.
Why he thinks that Richy Sick has the opportunity to take that belt away, to take my title shot away from me.
What?
Go ahead, tell him,
standing. You gotta love it, folks.
Next on Tough Talk, they're just gonna start jerking each other off.
You are gonna lose, Derek. Richy Sick always rises to the occasion.
And the crowd is calling for three more words from the horse face.
How dare you call him horse face? The man is a stellar human being, a very good-looking gentleman, by the way.
I got three words for you, pal. You can't win.
Yeah.
Whoa!
You can't win! I've known Richy Sick for almost my entire life.
That's right.
And I don't think there's anybody in here that can claim that they know Richy Sick better than me.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give me a valid reason why you believe that Richy Sick has even the slightest chance with me in the ring?
You tell that? Yeah.
Well, come on, Cam, let's tell him! Come on, let's tell
him!
You've never beat him! Never! Not once! Not one time have you ever beat him! Is this true?
You heard it on Tough Talk, folks. Never beaten Richy Sin. Yeah, you're right.
No!
Yeah, in the history of PCW, I've never beaten Richy Sin.
But you will!
That was hard to swallow.
Right here on Tough Talk, Derek Simonetti, Mr. of the World, never beaten Richy Sick.
What?
You've never beaten him, not one time. You never will. He's gonna destroy you. It's obvious, every single time. Every single time. For years upon years upon years. What makes you think this next time you're gonna win or something? Really? Really?
Boo!
So you think you've got everything sewn up? You think you know everything that there is to know. You are dead sure
that I can't beat Richy Sick. So you know about our 20-year friendship. Alright. And you know about what he did to me last year. Alright. So you know what comes next, right?
Yeah.
I know what comes next. What comes next? The bloodiest night in PZW history.
Between Malibu Stacy, Mr. Ed, and The Undertaker, I'm going to trust The Undertaker. And on that note, after this commercial break, Stevie James takes on Richy Sick one-on-one in On The Main Event.
You are only one click away from getting a free DVD from PZW. All you need to do is go to www.twitter.com and follow at PZ Wrestling. The first 100 followers will receive a free DVD from Project Zero Wrestling. Once again, that is twitter.com, follow at PZ Wrestling. Do it today. Is 15 minutes of PZW action not enough for you?
Then you should go to www.pzwrestling.com. It's a .com!
Where you can visit the PZW Newswire and get the latest news in the world of Project Zero Wrestling.
Check out our roster section to get a quick look at PZW superstars past and present. In the television section, check out your favorite Money Minute segments, as well as episodes you may have missed. And while you're there, subscribe to the YouTube channel.
And you can even like us on Facebook.
And you can follow your favorite PZW superstars on the Twitter.
Owen, I think it's Twitter.
Nah, whatever.
For all that and more, visit www.pzwrestling.com.
It's a .com!
Shut up!
All right, Rich, I'll shut up, all right?
All right, I don't think he was talking to you.
Of course he's not. He wouldn't tell Cam Cash's cousin to shut up. No one will.
Well, I don't know about no one. I certainly will. Owen Cash, we know it's a .com. Shut up.
Well, I'll be dead for you to say that to me. Mr. Fair, by the way, he's the referee in this match. Nice to see you, Mr. Fair.
Well, he's certainly putting in a lot of hours at the gym as he has lost a ton of weight since the last time I saw him officiate the match.
I hate this song so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, former Ideal Opportunity briefcase holder, former PZW Heavyweight Champion, the second champion in history.
And now, thanks for being here, Stevie James. This man is a former everything, and right now he is nothing to everything.
And this could, well, I kind of have to agree with you, but this could very well...
Oh, you gotta love it. That's sportsmanship at its best, folks. Ring the bell. Let's get this stud muffin of a match going.
This is a big match, ladies and gentlemen, because let's take a look at the facts, okay? Stevie James, starting from square one, once again, after being robbed of his Ideal Opportunity briefcase.
And Richy just going to town on that arm, folks. He's just wrenching it in. He knows he can beat Steven. Anybody can beat Steven. You gotta think mentally, Joe. After losing the briefcase, that was a guaranteed shot. What's Stevie's game plan now, going from bottom, now back to the top, trying to get there?
Richy in incredible ring shape, moving faster than I've ever seen him. Oh, come on, no, ref. Trying to separate the arm from the body of Stevie James.
Richy is going to take advantage of Steven's low self-esteem. Now, I'm going to call that one. That's what I think.
You think Steven's poor attitude, poor mood as of late is going to cause his demise in this match?
Absolutely. You got to think to yourself, although Steven hits him like he means it.
With a flying shoulder tackle, big elbow drop on the ground, and another one. Could we see a third one? And the point of the elbow meets the canvas.
Oh, here we go. Richy's going to give it over.
Stevie James and Richy Sick are in a very interesting position. Because let's look at this. Stevie right now, bottom of the ladder. But he's in the ring with the longest reigning PZW heavyweight champion.
Don't you forget it, baby.
Not only that, but Richy Sick is also in a position where he has a number one contenders match coming up in a few weeks against Derek Simonetti. If Stevie James can manage to defeat Richy Sick, I would have to imagine that the PZW Board of Directors and General Manager Shane Daly would have to look at that before deciding who will actually take on the PZW Heavyweight Champion.
Well, I don't think we have to worry about anything, because right now Stevie James is in a world of hurt, Joe, and I don't know if his arm's even going to be attached by the end of this match.
You know, some people could say that Steven lives in the world of hurt. Everything that's happened to him in PZW, I've never seen anybody start at the beginning more times than Stevie James. Kick out at two by Stevie, so he still has enough life in him to get out of that predicament.
Stevie fighting back now, but you got to imagine Richy Sick has seen this before. No matter what Steven does,
Richy's carry. Elbow number one, elbow number two. He's not making the same mistake twice and going after elbow number three.
Richy's got this. He knows exactly what he's doing. Steven is going to make a mistake sooner rather than later.
Complete shot from the second rope to the floor.
Or maybe not.
Richy Sick is a rag doll. This could be it.
One,
two, and a kick out at two.
Good God.
Let's take it to the replay. Stevie James runs up the buckle, and a complete shot puts Richy on his head. That could have easily been a three.
But Richy crotches him on the and nails him in the face with a big old punch.
Big European uppercut and a second one. Stevie James trying to fight back. Richy Sick yielding. Big elbow in the corner puts Richy Sick back on the offensive.
Richy ain't giving up, and neither is Steven. These men are going fist at
it
right now.
Fighting. Could we see the spinning DDT and a punch in the crotch that the referee did not call?
Hey, he's being fair. I didn't see it. Oh, backflip.
Pele kick to Stevie James in the corner. Richy backs up. Ritual from the second rope, and that's got to be it.
That is it, folks. It doesn't get any better than that. This man came to play. This man is all business, and he has his sights on being number one contender. Derek Simonetti.
Let's take a look at the replay. Richy runs up the buckle and almost snaps the neck of Stevie James with an incredible ritual.
I've seen nothing like that before. This man is ready to go. And now my cousin telling him to get out of the ring, especially when he should be.
KM Cash may very well have backed a winner, but we won't know for sure until Richy Sick steps in the ring one more time with the man he used to call friend, Derek Simonetti. Hey, PZW fans, the fun does not have to stop here. You can continue your PZW experience by going to www.pzwrestling.com or going to Twitter and finding @PZWrestling to catch up with all of your PZW superstars' thoughts and opinions of tonight's program. All that and much more can be found at www.pzwrestling.com.